Hey there, it's David from Project 42 Musician Rat and Nothing Gained. So today we're doing viewer requests. We're going to do a whole load of reactions this evening. So we're doing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 reactions we've got planned in for today. So we're going to check out, the first is a viewer request, and this is by Hating Me, is the requester, and this is between The Buried and Me and White Walls. Never heard the band, never heard the track, so looking forward to checking this one out. If you like the video, please subscribe, click the bell icon, like and share, leave the comments down below. Obviously check out the second channel, Musician Rat 2.0. If you've requested a song and you haven't seen it, check out the second channel. There's a good chance it's been uploaded on there. The second channel is not getting a lot of love at the moment, it's all on the main channel, so please do subscribe to the second one. Obviously check out the challenge videos. We've got 3 challenges currently live, which are, what we've got going on at the moment. It is greatest album ever, we have originals versus covers, and we have the greatest song written for a original song written for a video game. So go check those ones out as well. But let's go check this one out. It's a long ass song, so you're a sadist, you're asking me to check out a 14-minute song for a reaction. Thanks for that. Let's do this.
One of the exciting things about writing and teaching a sushi class is that I have skills and a story that I can share. And
should we skip this? What do you reckon?
Help me edit. I wasn't a writer. English is my second language, but I use Grammarly.
That's a nice instant reference straight in. There was like literally no intro. So I'm sounding like I could click the button and straight off. It's office going. So it's got an electronical style to their guitar riffs. It's not a lot of fat weight to it. It's basically, the whole track so far has been very mid. Wasn't expecting it to be metal, to be honest, based on the intro. Combination of like math metal, it's got like kind of weird throwaway like ideas of like the old jazz sort of like off the beat sort of tempos. It's kind of cool. I like the spiraling design of the guitar. I'm actually surprised by the fact that it's a 40-minute track with a song like this. From a vocal point of view, it doesn't lend itself to that way. It's that little jazz sort of style. Play a little of snare fills.
Yeah,
said, we've got 10 minutes more of this, so I'm intrigued because it feels like the song should be finishing. So are they going to do like multiple parts of the song? From a time signature point of view, it reminds me a little bit of like the Dream Theater style of music. Vocally completely different things, kind of like death metal does Dream Theater. Loving that eclectic sort of time signature. To a halfway point, I think. Yeah, just about halfway. So it's been interesting so far from the time signature sort of changes. I just haven't felt the musical journey so far. Mainly because the vocals haven't kind of locked me in. It's one of those ones that sounds like it needs to be a score to a... It needs a visual piece to it. I've said that a few times about sort of this sort of style of music. It feels it does need the same visual in front of it to help. I guess for the people writing it, it probably makes sense because they can visualise what the concept of it is. But for the listener, that's why you have to read the lyric sheets. You have to watch the videos of the guys that wrote it telling you what it's all about so you can help visualize what the journey is. Nice grooves on the track, that's cool. Nice harmonies, good use of the rise of the bell part, right? Little splashes going there. Clean vocals there. I don't think it needs the heavy. To me personally, that's quite a weak, heavy vocal. It's in key, but it just sounds a little bit too raspy overall. That sort of vocal stuff meant to intimidate that. To me, it just sounds like a younger person doing that vocal stuff. and we'll get into kind of a jazz kind of jazzy sort of style drum fill. Good use of chord structure, it's got a nice vibe to it, it's got some good tempo progressions of this section. But it's definitely the last part of the song that's feeling like more, I guess, commercial. It's got that kind of more accessible vibe, if you like. Fun beat to play. Okay. Okay, so That was between The Buried and Me and White Walls. As always, I always talk about being honest about my reactions, so I don't want to kind of go, oh my god, this is amazing, because that's what some of the reaction channels do, to try and get people, and they do like little images on the screen to tell you to come and check them out and subscribe, etc. So I wanted to be honest about how I felt about the track. So the thing for me is I didn't get the concept of the song. And remember, this is a reaction, so this is me coming to it completely blind, not knowing, not doing any research. This is just me, as though I was coming across this on a radio station, or someone said, yeah, check this band out, which is exactly what's happened. You guys have told me to check this band out, so I've checked it out. The bits that I liked, I liked their technicality. They've got some great musicians in this band. I liked the clean singer. I didn't really get the heavy singing over this sort of thing. If you're going to do a whole song where it's trying to tell a story, because that's what it felt like. It was like they were coming out, they were doing a piece that's trying to tell a story of a journey. The growly vocals for me didn't work. And then there was lots of little blast beats. There's lots going on in the whole track, but without any context, it doesn't work. You need to have context. Now, that's not saying that every song you ever listen to that has this sort of same formula of 40-minute long songs telling a story needs to have a context, because actually vocally they can have a context. You can feel it emotionally through the music. And so there are bands that have done it, and they've done it really well. This feels to me like a band who's trying to do something and has an idea, and they've done it. And musically, I guess from a technical point of view, it works. But from a storytelling point of view, they haven't quite got it yet. It would probably work if you were a Metallica style band and you did it, because people would know the context before they listen to it. But if you're a complete novice, you're just going straight in on this particular track, it's very difficult to kind of get your head around the whole idea of the track. That being said, as I said, I did like the musicianship of the track. I thought they were really, really good. They were a really strong musicianship. For the second half, or the last half, or last third of the track, was the strongest for me, personally. Mainly because it was the more commercial part. It was the more that was sort of locked in. It had a little bit more groove to it. It just worked a little bit better for me as part of a song. But that's my own thoughts. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments down below. Thank you very much for watching, as always. Thank you very much for hating me as the requester for requesting the track. It's always great to check out something new, throw something else new on the channel. Thank you very much for checking out, and I will see you on another video sometime very, very soon. Take care.